नमस्कार, ग्रेट मैन इंटरनेशनल स्कूल की ऑनलाइन क्लासेस में मैं आपका स्वागत करता हूं। कोविड-19 महामारी के इस दौर में मेरा ऐसा मानना है कि आपका परिवार पूरी तरह सुरक्षित है, स्वस्थ है और बच्चों ने लॉकडाउन में बहुत एंजॉय किया। अब मैं आपका सपोर्ट चाहता हूं इस ऑनलाइन क्लासेस में। बच्चों की शिक्षा को हम अब स्टार्ट करते हैं और बहुत ही जल्द जो भी आपका बैकलॉग है हम उसको क्लियर भी करेंगे और एक नए तरीके से आपकी शिक्षा स्टार्ट होने वाली है। पेरेंट्स का हमें पूरा सपोर्ट चाहिए। आप लोग पिछले 10 सालों से लगातार हमें सपोर्ट करते आए हैं और मेरा ऐसा मानना है कि अगर हम और आप मिलकर चाहेंगे तो बच्चों की शिक्षा का कोई नुकसान नहीं होने वाला है और हमें और आपको मिलकर अब एक रीस्टार्ट करना है। नाउ लेट्स रीस्टार्ट। बेस्ट ऑफ लक। नमस्कार।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम दिशा कृपलानी एंड टुडे आई एम हियर टू टीच यू साइंस फॉर ग्रेड 6। चैप्टर 1 इज सोर्सेज ऑफ फूड। फूड इज बीइंग ट्रीटेड एज अ फ्यूल फॉर अस। इट गिव्स अस एनर्जी, इट हेल्प्स अस टू ग्रो एंड टू स्टे हेल्दी एंड द केमिकल सब्सटेंस विच आर प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द फूड आर कॉल्ड न्यूट्रिएंट्स। दे हेल्प टू गिव नरिशमेंट टू आर बॉडी। So the chemical substances which are food inside, which are present inside the food are called nutrients. They help us to give nourishment. Okay, so there are some basic functions of food. What are these? That it provides energy for various activities of the body. It helps our body to grow and replace the dead cells. And it protects our body from various diseases and keeps it fit and healthy. As you have learned the 5 basic nutrients of food, that is carbohydrate, fat, mineral, protein, vitamins. So you know the basic functions, okay? As we can revise it, carbohydrates are energy giving food, protein is bodybuilding food, and vitamins and minerals are known as protective foods, okay? So next is variety of food that is being present in our country. As India is a vast country with different types of soil and different types of climate at different places, so there is variety of food is present in different regions of India. As the people, the food eaten by people of Kerala is not being eaten by the people of Kashmir. They eat different foods. Okay, that's why we say India is a very big country with different types of food items there. Next is, what are the main ingredients of food? The main ingredients of foods are like, yes, you'll say water and salt. Obviously, these two things we get from earth. And other than this, what are the basic sources of food? Tell me, the basic sources of food are plants and animals. Yes, plants and animals. Plants are called producers. Green plants are called producers. Why? Because they produce their own food in the presence of carbon dioxide, sunlight, chlorophyll and water. You know that. Okay. And from animals, what all things we get? We get milk, meat, eggs, honey from honey bees. These are the different things we get from animals. And the different things we get from plants, as you can see a big chart that is present in your book, it's fruits, leaves, stem, roots, different types of seeds that we eat and different types of flowers. So these are the basic 2 sources of food, that is plants and animals. Now animals cannot prepare their own food. They have to depend on plants or animals for their food. So there is a classification of animals on depending upon their food, what they eat. Okay, so there are 5 types of animals, like herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, scavengers and parasites. Okay, so we'll be learning one by one. First is herbivores. You must be knowing that what is herbivores. Herbivores are those animals which eat plants. As you can see in the picture, there is a picture of a cow and a horse eating plants. They feed on plants. That's why these animals are called herbivores. They have sharp cutting teeth and in front and flat grinding teeth at the back to chew the food properly. Okay. Next heading is carnivores. Carnivores are the animals that eat flesh, that eat other animals. They feed on other animals for their food. Animals like lion, tigers, wolves, dogs, snakes, these are the animals that are carnivores. They depend on other animals for their food. Third category is the omnivore. Omnivore are the animals that eat both plants and animals. They depend on both plants and animals. So this category is called omnivore. Okay, so which all animals will come under this category? Cockroaches, crows, bears, as well as humans. We are omnivore because we feed on plants as well as animals. So we are also omnivore. Human will come under omnivore category. Okay, next heading is scavengers. What are scavengers? This is a new term for you. Scavengers are the animals, or we call some of the animals as scavengers, which depend on dead animals for their food. They eat dead animals. For example, as you can see, crow, jackal, hyena, vulture, these are some of the examples of scavengers. They eat dead bodies of animals. Crow will come under this category as well as omnivore category because crow eats both plants and dead animals. So it will fall in both of the categories. The third and the last category is of parasites. This is also a new term for you. Parasites. Parasites are the animals that depend on other animals for their food, like other living organism for their food. For example, mosquito. Mosquito is a parasite. It has a long sharp pipe to suck the blood of a living being, okay, living human or an animal. Some of the other examples are leeches, bugs, fleas. They depend on other living organisms for their food. Some of the worms like tapeworm, ringworms are inside our body and they feed on the digested food by us. They live because of the digested, the food we eat. Okay, so these are the five categories. Again, we can revise it. Herbivores, they eat plants. Carnivores depend upon the animals for their food. Omnivores eat both plants and animals. Scavengers depended upon the dead animals. And the parasites live on other animals. Okay, they are dependent on other living animals for their food. Okay, so this is the classification of animals according to their food habits, their different food habits. Last topic is food chain. As you can see in the picture, there is a big chain-like structure you can see here in this. A grasshopper dependent upon the plants for their food. Frog is dependent upon the grasshopper for its food. Snakes eat frogs and eagle can eat snake for its food. So, this chain-like structure is called food chain. This is called food chain. Okay, this is a big chain. So, this is called a typical food chain. A smaller food chain's example I can give you. It is like deer feeding, as you can see in the picture, deer feeding grass. And a lion is dependent upon deer for its food. So, this is a smaller food chain. Likewise, you can find different food chains around you. This is the one of the activity for you. Find different food chains and note it down in your notebook. Okay. So this was the last topic of our chapter. And this is the way we have completed the chapter. Now I have attached assignment answers of exercises and question and answers in the description box. You can find it below. Do it. Do the homework. Study at home as the lockdown is going on and you are at home. So, take some time to study. If you have any doubt regarding any of the topics, you can comment down in the comment box. And if you have, if you again get some doubts, you can again see this video for some references. And stay at home, stay safe, wash your hands again and again, study. Okay? Thank you.